Hello, this is Fred Hooper with Imbue Effects. Tonight we're going to be adding a light to an emitter using Kismet and Matinee, and by the time we're done, should look something like this. So let's get started. Before diving into Kismet and Matinee, we have to make sure that our scene is set up with all of our elements. Now in this case, we need to have an emitter, a light, and a trigger. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to add in our emitter. Now Bill has been so kind as to lend me this effects explosion main, which is something he's going to be making into a full-fledged tutorial soon. So this is sort of a sneak peek of that. So let's left-click and drag it into the scene here. Move this off to the side. Let's position this right about here. Now next, we need to go into its properties and change one thing. So let's turn off auto-activate, since we don't want the emitter to fire off immediately when we drop into play and editor. So let's close this. So we've got our emitter. Let's add in a light. So hold down L and left click. Now this will bring in a point light. Now this isn't exactly the type of light we need since we're going to be using Matinee on this. We're going to need to change it into a toggleable light. So let's right click, convert light, point lights to point light toggleable. And the icon should change into this little clicker here, a light with a little clicker. Let's position that as close to the emitter as we can. Next thing we're going to need to do is we're going to need to change a couple of properties in here. So hit F4 again to open up your properties. Let's make the brightness 0 so that it's turned off when we start. And let's go down into movement, physics, change fizz none to fizz interpolating. Otherwise we'll get an error when we drop into Matinee. Now we can move it around, change it, make it bigger, smaller, whatever we want when we get into Matinee. So we got our light and our emitter. Next thing we need is a trigger. Now, way over here is my player spawn, because this explosion is freaking huge. So let's add a trigger in right here. So right click, add actor, add trigger. And here's our trigger. Now from here, again, we want to go into the properties and change a couple of things. So let's hit F4, change the collision height to 80 and the collision radius to 80. And then let's go down here. Now I want to be able to see it when I drop into the editor, drop into play and editor. So let's turn off hidden. So when we drop in, we should be able to see it. So we don't have to hunt around for it. Now that we've got all of our elements in place, let's jump into Kismet. So with the trigger highlighted, or selected, I should say, let's open up Kismet. Kismet button's right here. With the trigger highlighted, right-click in this field and start a new event using trigger 8, used, and it'll bring up a trigger used node. Now, of course, we need to change a couple of the properties here. Let's turn off aim to interact because I don't necessarily want to be looking at it to trigger it. Let's change our max trigger count to 0 so that we can spam it if we'd like. And then here's something I like to do. I like to add in an object comment. So when I actually trigger it, I want to make sure that it's actually being triggered. So call this triggered, and then output object comment to screen. That way this triggered will be spammed on the play and editor every time you hit the trigger. Next thing we need to do is add in the matinee. So hold down your M key and left click, and then string used to play, so that when you use this trigger, it'll start playing your matinee. Now in the matinee, we need to change one of the properties. Let's turn on force start position. So every time you hit this trigger, it should always go back to 0. So now we've got this all set up correctly. Let's double click on the matinee window and it'll bring up your matinee. Now if you've never used matinee before, it breaks down pretty simply. This is your timeline. Right now this is set to 5 seconds. And this is where all your tracks are. So your ways to set up keys to turn on and off lights, emitters, animations, and director tracks. Up here is your curve editor. You can change and edit curves here. Down here is your properties window. Now, the first thing we're going to want to do, let's move this over here. Let's highlight the emitter. And then to add a track, right click, and you'll have a bunch of track options. Now in this case, we want to add a new particle group. And it'll bring up this group name. Let's name it Explosion. and this will bring up a toggle track. A toggle track is just what it sounds like. We want to toggle this emitter on. So make sure that your slider is set to zero. You can do that a couple of ways. You can either manually left click and move your slider to zero, or if it's not on zero, you can double click your stop and it'll automatically snap to zero. Now we want to add a key. So to add a key, we can do it two ways. We can either hit our enter button or we can hit this button right here. In this case, I'm going to just hit this add key button, and it'll bring up this window for choosing a toggle action. In this case, I want to use a trigger. A trigger is a fire and forget, so we want to fire immediately when we hit our trigger. Okay, so now from here, I want to do a couple things. Let's hit play, and what I'm looking for is I'm looking to see like when the explosion ends. The reason this looks blue is because the emitter is selected. So let's deselect the emitter, hit play again. And it looks like it finishes around 2 seconds. We're going to use that 2 seconds to finish up all of our lights. So next thing we need to do is let's select the light, right click in this field, and add in a lighting group. Now let's name this lighting group Explosion Light. And this will bring up all these different tracks: movement, brightness, light color, and radius. Now we're only going to be messing with the last three. So the first thing we want to do is highlight the brightness track, have this set to zero, and add a key. This time I'm just going to use the enter button. And then hover over the key and right click, and let's set a value at zero. Now because we had set the value to zero in the properties, it should be set to zero already. I just wanted to verify that it was. Hit OK. And just move it over, just move your slider over just a little bit. Add another key and right click. Set this value to something crazy like 50. And you'll see that the light starts to blow out. Now slide this over to around 2. Add another key, right click, set this value to 0. Now if we hit stop and double click stop to have it go back to, have the slider go back to 0 and hit play, we'll see that the light blasts out and then slowly fades away. Now let's go to the radius, highlight that and add a key at 0. Right click and set this value to 0. What I want to try to do here is I want to try to mimic the way that the explosion grows by making the light grow. So let's go back to that, slide over just a little bit, add another key, right click, set this value, and this is a size value, so let's set it to 2048. You see the thing goes bonkers and it's just huge. And then at around 1.5, add a third key, right click, let's set this value to 1024, since it seemed like that one framed the explosion pretty well. Let's go back to zero and hit play. Now I don't like how the brightness of the explosion dies out, so let's change the curves on that. So to turn on the curve, hit this button right here on the track, on the brightness track, and then center your curve. Now the front end, I want to make it linear. And the back end, instead of it dying out really smoothly, I want to kind of die it out more abruptly. So let's highlight this key here, and then let's move the curve up. And we hit play. We'll see that the light lasts a little bit longer before it dies out. Now right now this light is bright white. We don't necessarily want that. So let's go back and change the light color. So at zero, let's add a key. I just want to leave it white, but I just want to show you that instead of a value for the color, the light color track, you'll get a set color track. So let's do that. Let's make sure it's set to white. Hit OK. And just slide it over just a little bit. Add another key, right click on the key and set a color. Now in this case, because the front end is pretty, is a really good orange, let's make it a nice rich orange color and hit OK. You'll see that it's changed to a really nice warm orange. Let's go back to zero, hit play. Now it seems that the end of it gets a little bit darker. So let's go to about 1.5 on the light color and add another key. Right click, set the color to like a little bit of a deeper red, make it a little darker. Hit OK. Let's hit play. Let's change the brightness just a little bit. It's a little bit too abrupt now, so let's have it die out just a little bit more smoothly. All right, that's about it. Now, at this point, because the timeline is only about 2 seconds long, but it's 5 seconds here as a default. It's going to be eating up extra cycles if this were part of a larger scene. So there's a couple ways you can clean this up. You can either left click on this red slider and move it as close as you can to the two, or if you want to be exact, you can right click on this key here and move to the longest track endpoint, and it'll be exactly on the last key of the last endpoint. So you won't be burning up any extra cycles. So now we're done in matinee. So let's close this. And because we had the emitter and the light highlighted, this was automatically strung up when the tracks were added. Our explosion and explosion light are populated. So let's close this. Okay, let's drop into Pi and see what we've done. So now, as you can see, I've got a trigger right here. Let's move forward, make sure that we're touching it, and hit enter, and there you go. As you can see, the triggered spam comes up so that I know that I've actually triggered the trigger, and the light works with the emitter. Okay, so tonight we've added an emitter, a light, and a trigger, strung it up in Kismet, and then ran it through matinee. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and thank you for coming to Imbue Effects. Have a good night.